Monroe's mother had always been much better at starting things than finishing them. When she died, she left behind over 300 canvases, not one of them finished, along with Monroe, who felt pretty unfinished himself. The orphanage allowed him to keep only one painting, and so he chose the unfinished swan that had always been his mother's favorite. But that night, he woke up to find the swan had disappeared. So he took his mother's silver paintbrush and followed the footprints into a little door he hadn't seen before. The king was young, arrogant, and amazingly talented. He was convinced no color existed that was good enough for his garden, so he left it white. While he pondered how to create some new colors, his kingdom began attracting settlers, and soon he found himself with bigger problems.
Hey!
The king's new subjects were tired of white. They were tired of tripping, of banging their shins, of misplacing their homes. So they started painting everything, ruining the king's spotless design. In response, the king outlawed all non-magical brushes and pledged to spend the next month painting shadows for his kingdom.
Whoa! Whoa.
Was designed to be beautiful, and it was. It was not designed to be practical, and it wasn't. Whole families got lost for weeks at a time, mail took months to arrive, and many worried a labyrinth of this size was bound to attract dragons. Eventually, the complaints grew so loud even the king couldn't ignore them. The king was so frustrated with the messy, demanding people of his kingdom that he decided to start over. One morning he painted a boat and set off to find the perfect spot. He told himself he'd come back someday to finish what he had started, but of course, he never did. Oh, For the first time in weeks, Monroe felt good. He felt even better when the wind pushed him close enough to reach the swan. He was feeling so good, in fact, that he forgot all about his fear of heights. But when the swan wriggled free and Monroe fell over the side, he remembered almost immediately. That might have been the end of Monroe if this were a shorter story, but it isn't, which is why Monroe's troubles were just beginning. Monroe scrambled out of the water and found himself in a massive city with no sign of the swan or anyone else. Well, except someone's enormous pair of feet. These were attached to a giant who could have been a big help in catching the swan, but unfortunately, here was the laziest giant who had ever lived, and it was his day off. Having celebrated in his usual way, he was now sleeping it off and quite unable to hear Monroe yelling. While he was looking for a way to wake the giant, Monroe noticed something even better: a floating ship. Sometimes the giant wondered about where all the people in the city had gone. Mostly he worried they might come back and ask him to clean their gutters or put out their fires. But they never did, and that was why the giant, who was the giant, wondered about where all the people in the city had gone. Thank you. Before he discovered painting, the king was a potter. He loved the simplicity of a well-spun pot. So when his subjects complained that his new city was too austere and that there was nowhere to relieve themselves, the king ignored them. But when they started relieving themselves in his pots, the king hastily built them a sewer system.
Thank you.
As the city filled up with people, the streets filled up with garbage. In a fury, the king painted over the roads with a canal, which swept away the trash, along with some of the slower children. But the water brought something else, a horde of vines which began covering the city.
Thank you.
Unlike his nicely trimmed hedge maze, the vines refused to stay where the king wanted them. He ordered his subjects to pull up every vine they saw. But the people were getting tired of the king's endless decrees, so they secretly began watering the vines whenever the king wasn't looking. The king hated the sea, and all because of his very first castle. It was the only one he had ever come close to finishing, and it took him a single day. But then the tide came in and washed it all away. He vowed that someday he'd build a kingdom that would last forever. Thank you. The vines were slowly burying the king and his city. No matter what he tried, the king couldn't stop them. So he decided to create something that could. He mixed in paint thinner, malice, and snot, and soon had the outlines of a pretty horrible creature. But it wasn't until the thing began to coil its tentacles and snap its jaws that the king understood what he had made. And for the first time in his life, the king was afraid. Even half-finished, the creature had no trouble swallowing up all the king's soldiers, half his zoo, and 3 peppermint gazebos. It was only with the help of his pet hippo and the giant that the king was able to force it into the sea. And though the water remained black for years after, the creature was never seen again on shore. Monroe waved goodbye to the giant and set sail. But no matter how fast he went, the swan was always just out of reach. And not for the first time that day, Monroe suspected he was being led somewhere. Then they flew into a cloud, and everything went black.